We are Israeli conscientious objectors. That means we refuse to serve in the Israeli army.
Because they are occupying another people, the Palestinians.
Palestinian kids can't go to school because of checkpoints.
Or even get health care.
Many young Palestinians go to prison for no reason.
A lot of them have been killed.
Or their homes demolished.
The government says this policy is keeping us safe.
But denying Palestinians their basic human rights puts us all in danger.
It's illegal.
It's wrong.
It's immoral.
It's against my personal beliefs.
When I was growing up, I believed in war heroes and dying for a piece of land and everything for my brothers and sisters here, the Jewish community in Israel. I wanted to be a soldier until I was like 17 or something. I was sure that that's okay, but when I was really small, I always cared about human rights, and my dream when I was like 8 was to be at Amnesty International and all those things. But I only awoke when I was about 16, 17, that all of those things I've been told in the education system and in my family and everywhere, you know, my friends, and it's everywhere in Israel. So maybe I should double check them. Maybe not everything is as I thought it was.
At what moment did you decide that you weren't going to do military service? Because everyone in Israel does. When did you decide, no, this isn't for me?
I was in the West Bank in a village called Shufa. I went there with a group called Combatters for Peace, which are ex-IDF soldiers and ex-Fatah people that decide to combat together for peace and not each other. And I went with them to this village in the West Bank. The Israeli army just put a checkpoint in the middle of the village for no reason, just to make it difficult for the people to cross. And we wanted to take it off. So they start shooting at us like crazy. And I didn't understand, like, is this the army all of my life I've been told is protecting me, now shooting at me? My whole idea of what they are is just vanished in like a couple of days.
Was it still a hard decision to refuse to join?
Of course it's hard, because in Israel, when you're born, you're a soldier to be, and your brothers and your sisters are soldiers, and your parents and your grandparents. It's not something that's far away from you. It's your best friends, and it's your ex-boyfriend. I don't know, it's like, and when you challenge them, and when you tell them in the face and in public, like I did, that you contempt them for doing that, for executing war crimes every day, they attack you personally. Although you don't do it, I didn't do it personally, you know. My opinions and my views are against using violence, not against my best friend who's, you know, just making coffee for this commander.
So how did you actually refuse? How did you say no?
You have a date for recruitment. Mine was in September, and I showed with a demo of like 100 people supporting me. I got in and I refused to recruit. So they took me to this judge, and before he judged me, he talked to me and he said, like, I believe you can change the system from the inside, and, you know, things like that. You can stand in a checkpoint and give a little children toffee. And I said that it doesn't matter if I give them toffee or not. I'm not supposed to be there, because in the end, I'm not letting them pass. And then I told him, you know, don't talk to me about changing the system from inside, because you're a very important general and you're still doing something against your will. So he got angry and sentenced me to the longest time of, you know, from our group.
It sounds pretty courageous. Did your family know you were going to refuse?
Yeah, my mom supported me all along. Like, she knew my opinions, and I started going like 2 times or 3 times a week to the West Bank and demo there. They knew I was doing political work already, and my father, it took me a long time to tell him, but, you know, it's my life. And he was very angry. It's very different from the path he chose. It is very hard for him, still.
Did you know that you were risking your relationship with your father when you made this decision to refuse to enlist?
I knew it, but I thought if I can overcome him being a militant, you know, army man, so he can overcome me being a pacifist and a refuser. I knew I have to go with my heart because I'm gonna live with myself, you know. I didn't want to regret for the rest of my life being a part of a system that is so wrong and so illegal and doing awful things.